Hello friends. This video is an update of my 2020 tutorial, in which I explained how to create a Telegram bot and connect it to Home Assistant to send various notifications. The reason for this update is that Home Assistant no longer supports configuring the bot via YAML. Everything has been moved to the interface. Otherwise, there have been no changes in how it works, so my other videos on this topic are still relevant, although I'll likely update some of them in the near future. For now, we'll start from scratch. Create and configure the bot. Set up your own Telegram channel where it will send notifications and integrate all of this in a Home Assistant. More details ahead, but before we start, as usual, I kindly ask you to like this video and leave a comment below. This helps with promotion via YouTube's algorithms. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, now is the perfect time to do so. At the time of testing, the current version of Home Assistant Core and Supervisor is July 1, 2025, and Home Assistant OS is 16.0. In this version, as I've already mentioned, the Telegram configuration has been moved to the user interface. That's why this tutorial needed an update. I'll start right from the beginning, creating your own Telegram bot. To do this, you use a special tool, a bot constructor. It's called Bot Father, and you'll find a link in the video description. Launch it with the Start button and choose the command, New Bot. This command launches the bot constructor. The first step is to set a name. This refers to the display name that you will see. You can use Latin letters, Cyrillic, or even hieroglyphs. The next step is to give it a unique technical username in Latin characters. Use underscores instead of spaces and add the word bot at the end of the name. After that, you'll receive a unique key, blurred out in this slide for obvious reasons, which gives you control over this bot. Now you can find it by its technical name. The chat with it will also show a start button, which initiates a conversation that is not yet configured. In this tutorial, I will only cover notifications, but in the video description, I'll leave a link to a tutorial on conversational setup. Another useful bot that you'll find handy lets you get user, group, and channel IDs. It's called GetMeAd_bot. When you start it, you'll immediately receive your user ID, which is needed for setup. If you need to get someone else's ID, just forward any message from that user to this bot. In the reply, it will show the sender's ID. You can use a direct chat with the bot for notifications, but this isn't very convenient if you plan to implement dialogue systems later. It's better to use a group or a channel. I prefer a channel, since you can add several bots to it if needed, and also an unlimited number of users who won't be able to post or interact with the bot, only view the notifications. Go to the chat creation menu and choose the option to create a channel. Come up with a name for it. Set the channel type to private, so people can only join via a link. By the way, in case you didn't know, Telegram allows you to generate invite links for such channels with a limited number of uses, or even one-time links, so they can't be forwarded. You can create as many channels as you need. For example, a general one for notifications relevant to everyone in your household, and a technical one, exclusively for system messages meant only for you. In order for the bot to post messages in the channel, it needs to be added as an administrator. For security, you can restrict its permissions by disabling any unnecessary rights. To add the channel to Home Assistant, we also need its ID. Send any message in the channel and then forward that message to the bot. In its reply, it will give you the necessary ID. Important note, group and channel IDs start with a minus sign. User IDs start with a number. For testing, I used one of my test servers, which you've seen in my other tutorials on setting up ZHA and ZigBee2 MQTT from scratch. Otherwise, it's almost a fresh installation. Go to the Settings menu. Since YAML-based configuration is no longer supported, we'll set it up via the interface. Go to the Integrations menu. In the bottom right corner, click the button Add Integration. In the pop-up menu, search for Telegram by name. We need to configure a Telegram bot, so choose the appropriate item. Here, choose the polling platform, and just below, paste the API key obtained when creating the bot. Done. The bot has been added. This is what the integration looks like now. It only contains one entry, the bot. Now you need to add the IDs of the users who will have permission to interact directly with the bot. For example, to send it commands. To just receive notifications, this is not necessary. You only need to add them to the channel. You also need to add the IDs of the groups and channels the bot can send messages to. There can be many users, groups, and channels. The bot is one. Adding them is simple and intuitive. After clicking the button, a window appears with an input field where you paste the IDs obtained using the bot I showed earlier. This is for adding a user. Adding a user allows them, if properly configured, to send commands to the bot that the system will process. If desired, you can create full-featured controls. Links to tutorials on this topic are in the video description. Same goes for the channel ID, which starts with a minus sign. I added one user and one channel. That's enough for notifications. Once again, to clarify, you can add an unlimited number of users to the channel, and they will be able to see everything the bot sends. Let's take a look at how sending notifications from Home Assistant to Telegram works. For experiments, it's convenient to use the Actions menu in the Developer Tools panel. Here you can test everything and then use it in automations. Select the Telegram bot message sending service. In the first menu, choose the bot for sending, the one we just added. Then, write the message it will send and specify the ID of the user, group, or channel to which the message will be sent. It's simple. After clicking the action execution button in the bottom right corner, if everything was done correctly, the bot will send a message, in this case, to the channel. Now let's create an automation. I'll start with the standard graphical interface automation builder. As a trigger, it can be anything, and if you want, you can add notifications to any process, for example, turning on the boiler, detecting smoke, water leakage, or opening the front door. For this example, I chose the section Starting or Stopping Home Assistant. Let's create a startup message for when Home Assistant launches. Select the appropriate item. In the Actions section, choose the Telegram bot message sending service. Next, everything is the same as we just did in the Actions menu of the Developer Tools. Choose the bot, write the message, and specify where to send it. Here's the full automation. Trigger, Home Assistant startup, action, sending a notification to Telegram. To test, I'm rebooting Home Assistant. After the system starts, the trigger of the automation we created will activate, and the bot will send the specified message. This use case I also use as a practical example of an automation that I personally use, although in a slightly extended version. For clarity and ease of copying, it will be formatted as a package. But before that, I'll remind you how to hide sensitive information in Home Assistant, in this case, identifiers. There's a built-in tool for this, the secrets file located in the root folder. I need to hide the user and chat IDs. In the secrets file, you specify a reference name that will then be used, followed by a colon, then the actual value hidden behind that reference. In this case, instead of the user ID, I'll use the reference chat ID user, and for the channel, chat ID channel. In the same way, you can hide any keys, API tokens, credentials, and so on. To make the secret references available in the system, you need to restart Home Assistant. Now let's add another integration that's useful for notifications. These are the date and time sensors. They are added through the integrations menu. The integration offers several sensor formats that differ in how they display data. I usually use the format time and date. This is how the integration looks. For now, there is only one entity, but if needed, you can add others if you want different display formats. To see the name of the created sensor, click on its row in the integration list. In the window that opens, we see what it displays and its change history. In the top right, click the gear icon. This opens the settings menu. Here you can set a custom name, which will be shown in the interface, optionally change the icon, and, which is useful now, copy its technical name. Before I move on to creating a package for the startup notification, I delete the test automation from the builder so there won't be duplicate notifications. Just in case, let me remind you, for the system to work with packages, in configuration.yaml, under the Home Assistant section, you must specify the packages platform with a path to the packages folder. In this example, All files stored in the includes folder and its subfolders will be treated as packages. And in that folder, I create a new file, a package, which I named notification.yaml. You'll find a link to it in the video description. Now I'll repeat the same automation I showed in the builder, but with some enhancements. The trigger remains the same, Home Assistant startup. The action, sending a notification, and instead of specifying the ID directly, I use the reference to the secrets file where that ID is stored. In the message being sent, I use emoji codes at the beginning of each line and also include data from the datetime sensor. Emoji code tables can easily be found online. You can also paste them directly into your code. Almost always it works fine. I'll leave a link to one such table in the video description. Let's test how this package-based automation works. I'm rebooting Home Assistant again. Thanks to the emojis, the message looks a bit more engaging, and it includes the date and time of its generation. Now let's add telemetry elements. The great thing about packages is that you can use a wide variety of platforms and integrations in a single file. In this case, I added 4 template sensors. Each of them counts the number of unavailable entities of different types: light, switch, sensor, binary underscore sensor. The formula loops through all entities of the specified type and sums up those that have the status unavailable. For testing, I stopped one of the integrations, as a result of which, there are several unavailable entities of various types in the system. The template code is checked in the developer tools on the templates tab. In this case, it returns the value 1, meaning 1 light is currently unavailable. Let's check on the states tab. And yes, that's correct. On this server, there is only 1 light, and it is currently unavailable. Now the startup message can be extended. For the template sensors to have time to load and return accurate values, all integrations must be fully loaded, which may take a while. So, between the startup message and the message with unavailable entities, there needs to be a delay. Usually 1 minute is enough, maybe a little more or less. It depends on the system configuration. Then, similar to the first startup message, I create a second one, which includes data from each of the created template sensors. In this example, 4 sensors, but you can just as well create others for different entity types: climate, cameras, fans, and so on. Now let's see what the final version of the server startup notification looks like. Thanks to it, you not only know that the server has started, but also get an understanding of the system status, whether everything is working or there are issues that require your attention. Essentially, the process hasn't changed much. Instead of a few lines of code in the configuration file, now the bot key and identifiers must be added through the graphical interface. But the logic of further usage remains the same. From my experience, such notifications are a very convenient and useful feature of the system. All important and even emergency events will be sent via Telegram to everyone who needs them, anywhere in the world with internet access. And this works without needing to install the Home Assistant mobile app or set up remote access. For those users who have permission to interact with the bot, sending commands will be available. That's all for now. I hope you found this video interesting and useful. I'll be grateful for your likes. They help promote the video on YouTube. If you don't want to miss new videos, subscribe to my channel. In the description below the video, I'll leave links to all the resources mentioned, as well as to my Telegram channels and social networks, and groups for smart home discussions. Join, it'll be interesting. Thanks for watching. Until next time, peace to all.